let us start single phase transformer. A transformer is a device which uses the phenomenon of mutual induction to change the values of alternating voltage and currents. Alternating voltage can be increased or decreased by transformers. Like the power station, transmission lines, distribution lines, there are different voltage level, and those voltage can be step up or step down only by using transformer. The first advantage of transformer, it is economical to transmit the energy at high voltage. By using suitable transformer, it is possible to transmit the energy in AC at desired high voltage. And the second one, for distribution purpose, the higher voltage can be stepped down with great convenience by means of transformers. And the third one, since its basic construction requires no moving parts, it is often called a static transformer. Being static, they have a long life and are very stable. And the fourth point, losses in transformers are generally low and thus efficiency is high. Consider two winding transformer. This is primary side and this is secondary side. N1 is the number of turns in the primary winding and N2 is the number of turns in the secondary winding. In secondary side, load is connected and alternating supply voltage V1 is given. When load is not connected, a small current called no load current flows, which produces an alternating flux in the core. Actual small current is responsible for producing the flux. This alternating flux links with both primary and secondary winding and induces EMF V1 and E2 by mutual induction. When secondary side is open circuited, that is load is not connected, no current will flow in the secondary side. Assumptions are made for ideal transformer. The first one, the primary and secondary winding resistance are negligible. The second one, there is no leakage flux and all the flux setup is confined to the core and links both the windings. And the third one, hysteresis and eddy current losses in transformer core are negligible. And the fourth one, the core has infinite permeability so that the magnetizing current required to produce the flux and establish it in the core is negligible. Operating principle. Induced EMF E in a coil of N turns is given by equal to minus N divided by dt. Polarity of the induced EMF is given by Lenz's law, so it is negative. In an ideal transformer, d5 by dt is same for both primary and secondary because phi links with both primary and secondary winding. So you can write E1 equal to minus N1 d5 by dt and E2 equal to minus N2 d5 by dt. So we can write E1 by N1 equal to E2 by N2. That means induced EMF per turn is constant. Losses are negligible. We can write V1 by N1 equal to V2 by N2. So come to this figure. This is V1, the primary side voltage, and this is the V2, is the secondary side voltage. So we can write V1 by V2 equal to N1 by N2 is equal to K. Constant K is called voltage transformation ratio. If K less than 1, then V2 greater than V1, it is called step-up transformer. And if K greater than 1, then V2 less than V1, it is called step-down transformer.
Suppose N1 equal to 100 and N2 equal to 200. So you can write K equal to N1 by N2. That means half. So K less 1. So it is step up transformer. So you can write V1 by V2. That is N1 by N2 is equal to K. So V1 by V2 equal to half, or V2 equal to 2V1. So V2 greater than V1. So it is also the step up transformer. Primary and secondary volt amperes are equal, so we can write V1I1 equal to V2I2. This is the primary side voltage, primary side current, secondary side voltage, secondary side current. So we can write V1 by V2 equal to I2 by I1 equal to N1 by N2 is equal to K, or I2 by I1 equal to N1 by N2. So we can write I2 by N2 equal to I1 by N1. The rating of a transformer is stated in terms of the volt amperes that it can transform without overreading. Transformer rating is either V1I1 or V2I2, where I2 is the full load secondary current. EMF equation. As the applied voltage is sinusoidal at the primary, the flux produced by the exciting current is also sinusoidal. So we can write flux equal to flux max sine omega t. We know equal to minus n d phi by dt, or equal to minus n. Now put this value. After derivative, we get as the omega equal to 2 pi f. The maximum value of the induced EMF when the cos omega t equal to 1. So we can write E max equal to 2 pi f flux max n. Dividing both sides of equation 1 by root 2, we get E max by root 2 equal to 2 pi by root 2. Or we can write or ERMS equal to 4.44 f n flux max. This is the EMF equation. Now the induced voltage at the primary is given by E1 equal to 4.44 f n1 phi max, and similarly at the secondary we get as the induced voltage in the primary winding is equal and opposite to the applied voltage. So we can write the V1 equal to 4.44 f n1. EMF equation. This problem, the primary winding of a 50 Hz transformer is supplied from a 440 volt 50 Hz source and has 200 turns. Find the number 1, the peak value of the flux, and number 2, the voltage induced in the secondary winding if it has 50 turns. F equal to 50 Hz, E1 equal to 440 volt, N1 equal to 200. As the induced EMF in the primary winding is equal and opposite to the applied voltage, so we can write E1 equal to 440 volt. We know that E1 equal to 4.44 f phi m n1. From here we can write the phi m E1 4.44 Fn1. Now put this value. After computing this, we get phi m equal to 0.0099 weber. Now the number 2, the voltage induced in the secondary winding if it has 50 turns. So you can write E2 equal to 4.44 F phi m into, now put this value, 50 0.0099 into 50 is a 50 turns. So you can write, after computing this value, get this. Come to the second problem. A 200 kVA single phase transformer has 1000 turns in the primary and 600 turns in the secondary. The primary winding is supplied from a 440 volt 50 hertz source. Find the number 1 secondary voltage at no load and number 2 primary and secondary currents at the full load. We know that the primary kVA is equal to secondary kVA is equal to 200. So you can write E1 I1 equal to E2 I2. Let the primary and secondary current at full load be I1 and I2. So you can write, let the N1 equal to N2 and E1. Now E1 by E2, we know that is equal to N1 by N2, or E2 equal to E1 N2 by N1, that is equal to 440 600. After computing this value, you get this. Now the number 2, the primary and secondary currents at the full load, I1 440, after computing this, we get. Now the secondary current I2, put the value of I2, 264, after computing this, impedance transformation. Come to this figure. An impedance Z2 is connected across the secondary winding at its output. The primary winding is connected to a voltage source V1. The number of turns in the two windings are assumed to be N1 and N2. Induced EMF, E1 and E2 are in phase opposition to V1. Since V2 is a secondary terminal voltage, it is also in the opposite phase of V1. The impedance Z2 dash, as seen from the input side, can be obtained by dividing voltage V1 by I1. So we can write Z2 dash is equal to V1 by I1. Multiplying both sides by V2 I2. So you can write V1 by V2 I2 by I1 into V2 by I2. We know that the V1 by V2 equal to E1 by E2 equal to N1 by N2 is equal to K, the voltage transformation ratio or the turns ratio. So we can write Z2 dash is equal to K into K into Z2, that means K square Z2. So you can write Z2 dash is equal to K square Z2. Therefore the impedance transformation ratio is equal to the square of the turns ratio, that means Z2 dash by Z2 is equal to K square. In an ideal transformer, we can write voltage are transformed in the direct ratio of currents, that means V1 by V2 equal to K. Number 2, currents are transformed in the inverse ratio of turns, that means I1 by I2 equal to 1 by K. And the third point, volt amperes of two sides are equal, that means V1 I1 equal to V2 I2. And the fourth point, impedance are transformed in proportion to the square of the turns ratio, that means Z2 dash equal to K square Z2 and Z1 dash is equal to 1 by K square Z1. So, referring to the primary and secondary side, this transferred impedance is known as the equivalent impedance on that side. Impedance transformation.